design. It's an extensive green roof at the top to help us mitigate rainwater, and the building is cool about pumping in water from the Chicago River. Our last mayor, Mayor Daley, was on a quest to make Chicago the most vibrant and friendly city in the U.S. And if you look at the great seal of Chicago, you can find a Latin phrase that says Urbs in Virto, which means city with a garden. On it, right, one of the largest limestone buildings in the world. In fact, it was the largest until the Pentagon was completed in Virginia. This is the Chicago Merchandise Market, built in 1933 by Grand Madison Brooks White. It has 8 miles of corridors, and at one time it even had its own zip code. So it's just how massive this building actually is. Those sculptures of heads are known as merchants, Marshall Field, Montgomery Ward, and Siri Pro, which is the view then. At one point was downtown Chicago in the 1830s. There were a few bars, a few cabins in this location. And it was at one point where Chicago was in its name.
Right there.
Alive with a Native American word called Shugagua, which means strong, powerful smell. There were wild legends growing on the base of the river that time that smell permeated over the city. Like waking up in the morning, the smell of onions. We're going through a section of the river called the Junction. The main, north, south branch of the river all converge around Wolf Point. My city's rise and buildings and infrastructure for the city. It's exactly what we're presenting is the Junction of the river. We're going to be going under an elevator bridge, this is Lake Street. On the top works are reading people on L. L is short for Elevated Railroad, just spelled with L. Second, the most auto and pedestrian traffic. And underneath the bridge are the blue lights of Montgomery Airport. Features a Boeing store for all your Boeing shopping needs. Unfortunately, they don't sell any airplanes. Now, the issue with this building is in the southwest section, that we're now passing, they cannot drive pylons into the bedrock because of railroad switching tracks in the lower level. So, they have come up with a way to suspend this entire southwest corner. And what they don't do is create a series of 5 trusses. If you look up and back, you'll see a large X on top of the building. That is one of the trusses that is suspending that entire section. So it's lifting it above the railroad. On the right, 2 North Riverside, started in 1929 by Grant Madison, Brooks and White. Former headquarters of the Chicago Daily News. Barges are pulled up on the lower level where a water taxi now docks to pick up newspapers to the loop of the city. You can take a water taxi from Michigan Avenue to the South Clark, to Madison Street, and down to Chinatown.
The city of Willis and our next one from Grand Anderson, Brooks, and White. Mission by
Stanley. We want to earn their 2 and that one black building stairway 1 to get their 2. Both built in the early 60s by Steve Rhodes and Barrow in the Miesian style. As if you easily try it, folks, Mies van der City of Less is More. A lot of architects at SOM during the early 60s was too much under Van Der Elm. Obviously, like this philosopher number 2.